You might recognize our next guest from one of many TV shows, Chopped, Iron Chef America, The Best Thing I Ever Ate, Bravo's Top Chef, or even going way back to good old Queer Eye for the Straight Guy. Ted Allen is in Kansas City this weekend, and he is sitting next to me right now. Welcome, welcome, my friend. What brings you to Kansas City?
I'm here for the Hen House Holiday Celebration, which I'll be appearing at today at 11 and 1, cooking demonstrations, trying to encourage people to cook some interesting stuff. And then tomorrow at the celebration, Lydia Bastianich, one of the greatest chefs in the country, will be also appearing, so it's going to be a fun time.
Good. I've always wondered, since you're a chef, do you have a favorite dish, something that you always order when you go to a restaurant?
I'm really partial to duck, which is one of the things I'm going to demonstrate today, and yet, ironically, even though everybody in America is surrounded by ducks, and we see ducks all day long, not that many people are comfortable cooking it, and I want to show people that it's easy, and it's also less expensive than a lot of other sort of special occasion foods like steak.
So. Now, you are a cookbook author, and I want to ask, how do you feel about all the celebs out there with their cookbooks? You're a chef, so you know, but how do you feel about the celebs out there with their own cookbooks?
You know, when you work at Food Network, you learn very quickly that when you meet fans and viewers, that everybody has an idea in their head for a cooking show. Why? Because everybody eats. When celebrities who aren't from the culinary world make cookbooks, I think it's kind of an interesting window into their lives, into what they love to do. What I wanted to do with my cookbook was, I think most of the cookbooks out there are designed to get you out of the kitchen as fast as possible. 15-minute meals, 5-second meals, food that cooks itself.
I want a 5-second meal recipe. That's awesome.
Exactly. Food that requires no work. I look at cooking as something that's fun to do, that's creative, that's artistic, that's, you know, generous and about love and family and friends. And so my book is, it's not that it's difficult, it's just that it's from the perspective of, let's look at cooking as something fun to do, like painting a picture or making a sculpture or playing golf, none of which I do, actually. I just go to the kitchen and turn on the stereo and call my friends.
What is the single best dish you've ever had, the one that you were like, this is bliss?
Narrowing it down to one, I have to say I'm lucky in my line of work because I get a lot of great food. on Chopped, it's sometimes good, sometimes not, because it's terribly difficult. I had dinner last night at the local, which was awfully nice. Really great tenderloin, really great kale salad. The great thing about the food revolution that's happened the last couple of decades is that there are wonderful farm-to-table, serious-focused chefs in every city in the country. And it's a real treat for me to get to have some great food in Kansas. If it's not duck, it's probably Thanksgiving turkey, probably.
Okay, I'm right there with you. That is my favorite meal all year, I must say.
And it's really all about the stuffing.
Agreed. Oh, we're right there. We're on the same page.
It's a vehicle for butter and sage.
All right, next year it will be 10 years since Queer Eye for the Straight Guy debuted.
Don't remind me.
Wait. I am that guy. Look what I brought today. Look, it's the original, and look, you'll notice my name is down there. Excellent.
Okay, I'll tell you a funny story about this.
Okay.
This was one of the biggest moments in my life.
Yes.
Being on the cover of Entertainment Weekly. Carson styled us as
oh, of course he did.
And you'll notice that Carson always made sure that he was Diana Ross and we were the Supremes. So Carson wears all white, and the rest of us are in black and white. And when they put this banner right across his midsection, I'm sure it drove him crazy. I love him to death.
So there you go. It took a while to find this, but I just wanted to show you that I was a huge fan. So there you go.
Oh, thank you. I so appreciate that. Queer Eye, 10 years next July. I can't believe it.
Try and wrap your brain around that.
What's hardest to believe is that we're all still alive. Amazing.
And thin and pretty.
Fairly thin.
I'll give you that. Okay, so you went to local last night. Where else are you going to grub out? Where does Ted Allen when he is in Kansas City?
You know, the crazy thing, well, actually, Aaron Sanchez has a restaurant here, too. But the crazy thing is that when I'm traveling on something like this, I'm going to this event. I'm going to do two cooking demos and two book signings. I look at the schedule. There's never a time for me to eat, ever. I don't eat, so I don't eat. That's why I'm not obese. I don't get to eat.
Oh, bless your heart. Okay, so big event coming up. You're here today. Cooking for?
The Hen House Holiday Celebration, Overland Park Convention Center. We will be lots and lots of people. It's very inexpensive. I think it's $7 at the gate or $5 in advance if you go to Hen House and buy your tickets. And we'll be showing people how to cook, tasting wine, celebrating, and giving you ideas for making a creative holiday.
And duck, and lots of duck.
Duck, and duck fat potatoes, and some really interesting desserts.
I love it. Well, you are so sweet. It's nice to finally meet you.
Thank you. It's great to meet you, too.